are so big, we can all fit into his shoes. It's Fern and Kay.
Hello and welcome to All Star Family Fortunes, a show where we ask 100 people a range of everyday questions. Now, this week, we asked 100 exorcists if they've ever seen a ghost. They were all afraid to answer. Yeah? In case it came back to haunt them. So, the aim of the game is very simple. Two families have to guess the top answers to the surveys we've carried out. Get them right, and they could win up to £30,000 for a charity of their choice. But get them wrong, and they'll hear this. Tonight, the families will be battling it out for their cash, and they are from two of Britain's favourite soaps. Who's going to clean up tonight, and who's going to get into a lather? Well, let's find out. Let's meet them. Our first family features the boss of the sweet factory in Emmerdale. Yes. And he's hoping to put in a tasty performance tonight. Give it up for Rick McCarron! Very good. Pleasure to have you on the show. Where have you brought your family from, Rick?
We've come all the way from Chesterfield.
Oh, very nice. Very nice. Please, Rick, introduce me to your family.
Yes, this is my wonderful mum, Mandy.
Hi, Mandy.
It's my brilliant father, Marwan.
Hi, Marwan. Hi.
Wacky sister, Nicole.
Hi, Nicole.
And mental cousin, Becca.
Hi, Becca.
Hi, Vernon.
All right, so he may be the boss of the sweet factory on Emmerdale, but has he got a soft centre when he's at home? Let's find out.
I'm Mandy. I'm Rick's mum. This is my house in Chesterfield where Rick comes to escape from the windy moors of Emmerdale. Come on in.
Rick is incredible at martial art. He was awarded his black belt in Taekwondo at the age of 10. Never pick a fight with him.
Composes his own music, and even from a young age, he had a very mature taste. He loved Simon and Garfunkel.
Despite being born in Chesterfield, Rick actually loves Scotland, and he won an award for a Scottish dialect. Rick's sisters are really protective of him. Anyone wanting to date him will have to get past them first.
Not today, sorry, love.
Rick is a favourite with the ladies, and in 2010 was nominated for Sexiest Male.
Not that type of male.
Rick may run a sweet factory in Emmerdale,
but we're hoping the opposition will feel sour on Family Fortunes tonight.
Hey, Rick, just tell me, what's this award you won for Scottish dialects? What's that involve?
Well, we don't really need to talk about that, do we?
No, I think we should, ladies and gentlemen. Let's talk about it. So, basically, was it a Scottish impression? Is that it?
No, it's about doing the accent, you know.
All right, OK, well, can you give us a guided tour of
Scotland? Then he can, you're saying, like, yeah. So I'm going to go down to Edinburgh, sit in a flat in Leith, probably go across to Glasgow, and that is when I'll decide to be an actor.
Yeah?
Yeah? Any? Wow. Yeah.
That was great. That was good. So what do you want me to watch? Tonight is all about winning money for charity, Rick. Which charity are you playing for?
Yeah, we're playing for the Ashgate Hospice, which is a local charity in Chesterfield. They provide specialist care for terminally ill people and support their families. It's a very special charity.
All right, well, good luck, and more important, because it's local as well. So give them a big round of applause. Of victims, sorry, contestants. Where's he come on? Let's meet them. Our next family features an actress who lives on the streets. I just hope her performance is quality. It's Brooke Vincent! Very good. Got a lot of male admiration in the audience there. Hey?
I think it was from a granddad, but, you know.
All right, Brooke, welcome to Family Fortunes.
Thank you.
A pleasure to have you on the show. So please, Brooke, introduce me to your family.
OK, well, I've brought my lovely mum, Nicola.
Hi, Nicola.
Hi, Vernon.
I've brought my mum's partner, John.
Hi, John.
Hi, Vernon.
I've brought my lovely granddad, John.
Hi, Grandad John.
Hi, Vernon.
That's why it says that on the badge, Grandad John. Yeah, so we don't get confused.
My uncle, David.
Hi, David.
Hi, Ben.
All right, so let's check out where this soap dish lives.
Hi, I'm Nicola, Brooke's mum. Welcome to Manchester and the home where my soap star princess lives. Come on in.
We always knew Brooke was going to be a star. As a child, she loved performing as Spice Girls, as long as she played every part.
Brooke has hundreds of pairs of shoes and she loves nothing more than putting on her most sparkly ones and dancing the night away.
Brooke's pride and joy is her car. She uses it like a second home. It's so crammed full of stuff, she could survive in here for weeks. You name it, she's got it.
Brooke has always been a hard worker. Despite starting curry at the age of 11, she's worked at a florist, a hairdresser's...
Been anywhere on your holidays recently?
You can still be seen pulling pints at her friend's bar.
Cheers! Cheers.
Brooke is really into her music, especially R&B and rap.
Brooke is very much like her character. She's a real fighter.
And tonight, we are going to fight our way to the final and win big money on Family Fortunes.
Come on, Vincent!
You got me! Now, Grandad, I've got a gift for you. All right, Grandad John. The thing is, we know you enjoyed that scene so much with the rapping that we're going to make you wear this. For the first part of the show, we're going to fling you up. There you go. Hey?
Oh, he does.
Nice. He actually suits you.
A bit more at home now.
He matches your hair. So what charity are you playing for tonight?
We're playing for When You Wish Upon a Star. It's just a local charity that grants children with severe illnesses, wishes, really.
All right, excellent stuff. Well, we wish you all the very best of luck and a big round of applause to Vincent! All right, we've got our families and we've done loads of surveys, so what could possibly go wrong? Oh, let's find out. Rick and Brooke, come and join me as we play Family Fortunes. Rick. One hand by your buzzer, one hand behind your back. Good luck to you both. Here we go. We surveyed 100 people. We're looking for the top six answers. It's single money, so every point is worth a pound. Name a musical instrument you blow.
Oh, yeah. A trumpet.
Oh, yes, a trumpet. Our survey says... top answer. Do you want to play our passport? We're going to play. All right, Rick, go back to your family, start conferring. You might get the chance to steal, and we'll come to you, Mum. Nicola, what do you think? Name an instrument you blow.
Bagpipes.
Bagpipes, eh? Bet Rick with his Scottish accents all over bagpipes like a rash. Aye. Let's have a see. Bagpipes. Our survey says... it's not there, Mum. Unlucky. John, what do you think? Did you borrow that shirt off Harry Hill?
I'm going to go with a recorder.
Recorder, yes, a recorder. Nice, let's have a look. Our survey says... yes, well done, John. Second most popular. Excellent stuff. Grandad John, what do you think?
Saxophone.
A saxophone, nice. Name a musical instrument you blow. Saxophone, we like that. Let's see if it's there. Our survey says... yes! But not only that, John. That noise means you, my friend, have won a spot prize. Take a look at this.
Well, this is a fair way to spend a weekend, John, as you've just won a His and Hers luxury break. Yes, you and the missus will be heading to the luxurious Stoke Park Country Club and Resort for an amazing weekend for two. This is the height of relaxation. Who's the caddy?
Very nice. One of the best golf courses in the country, John.
Yeah.
Great prize. Congratulations. Well done.
Thank you.
David, name a musical instrument you blow.
Trombone.
Trombone. Yes, the trombone. We've had trumpet, recorder, saxophone. You've lost a life. David, you're saying a trombone. Our survey says... Yes, well done. It's there. The fourth most popular answer. Two lives left. We're still looking for two more answers. Brooke, what do you think?
A flute.
A flute. You play
Did you see how I pronounced my T then? I was just going to call it a flute.
Flute. Is it what you want to A flute. Let's have a look. Our survey says... Yes! Well done. Now, Mum, Nicola, your Brooke has been performing from such a young age, hasn't she?
She certainly
has. She's been a little star. In fact, we've got a little video, Brooke, of you in your front room.
Are you
performing Goosey Goosey Gander.
A what?
Yeah, take a look, it's brilliant. Apparently, Brooke, your mum told us that that's exactly how you sound when you're walking after a night out with your colleagues from Coronation Street. So, Nicola, what do you think? Name a musical instrument you blow. We're only looking for one more answer. You've got two lives left.
Mouth organ.
A mouth organ, yes. Also known as a harmonica.
That's
harmonica.
The one.
Yeah, harmonica. Stick with me, kid.
Mouth organ, where we come from, Bernie.
Hey, come on. Is it the fifth most popular answer? Our survey says... No, it's not! So the pressure's on you now, John. You've got one life left. We're looking for the final instrument that you blow.
Anything. A whistle.
A whistle. A whistle. Yeah, a whistle. Yeah. There was always a place for the guy with the whistle at my school. Yeah. Let's have a look. Whistle. Our survey says... No, it's not there. Unlucky. All right, let's see if the Macarons get the chance to steal. Becca, what do you think?
A tuba.
A tuba, yes. Nicole.
Oboe.
All right, oboe, Marwan.
Recorder.
Recorder, we've had that. Mandy, what do you think?
Bagpipes.
Bagpipes, yeah.
That, I think. I'm going to go with what Becca said, and I'm going to go with the tuba.
The tuba, all right. Is it the missing instrument? If it is, you've stolen from the Vincents. Our survey says... No, it's not! Wow! I don't think there are any more off the top of my head. Audience, what do you think? Any ideas? A clarinet! A clarinet! The audience is saying a clarinet. That's a good answer. Let's see if it is. Clarinet, what's the fifth most popular answer? The horn! Yeah. Yep. The horn. So, at the end of the first round, the Macarons have yet to score, but in the lead with 8-7, it's the Vincents! Now then, gang, the good news is we're going to have a break, so you get time to collect yourself and compose yourself, all right? The bad news is you've got to come back after it. All right, join us after the break for more Family Fortunes. Fortunes. Tonight, it's a soap special with Corrie's Brooke Vincent versus Emmerdale's Rick McCarron. It's the boss with the sweeties versus the sweetie from the streetie. So far, the McCarrons have yet to score, but in the lead with 87, it's the Vincents! All right, Mandy, I'm Nicola. Come and join me. Let's continue playing Family Fortunes. Nicola, Mandy, Nicola. One hand by your buzzer, one hand behind your back. Good luck to you both. It's still single money. We surveyed 100 people looking for the top six answers. Name a starter that's often on the menu in a restaurant. Nicola.
Prawn cocktail.
Prawn cocktail, yes. Our survey says... Oh, it's only the second most popular answer. Mandy, if you can find the top answer, you'll get control of the board. What do you think? Name a starter that's often on the menu in a restaurant.
Mackerel?
Mackerel. Oh, you're posh. A bit too high though for this shot of Andy, my friend. Our survey says it's not there. You've got to lower it a little bit.
I know
what I mean? Lower your standards. Just for tonight. Nicola, you get the chance to choose whether you want to play or pass. Do you want control of the board?
Please.
We're going to play. All right, Mandy, go back to your family, start conferring. You might get the chance to steal. We'll come to you, John. Name a starter that's often on the menu in a restaurant, John.
I'll go for garlic mushrooms.
Garlic mushrooms. Yes. Garlic mushrooms. Let's have a look. It's there. I can just imagine Peter Kay watching this at home now. Mushrooms? Garlic? Garlic mushrooms? Hey, crikey, I'd never have guessed. Grandad John, I'll tell you what, give me that necklace. It looks ridiculous now, I'll be honest with you. There you go, give me that. We'll give it you after. There you go, thanks very much. Yeah. Christmas present. What that like. Right, Grandad John, what do you think? Name a starter that's often on the menu in a restaurant.
Soup.
Soup, that's more like it. Let's have a seat. Our survey says... Yeah! Mushrooms. All right, it's going to get tough now because garlic mushrooms had 8 people in the survey. David, you've got to think outside the box, maybe. Name a starter that's often on the menu in a restaurant.
Garlic bread.
Garlic bread. Let's have a see. Garlic bread. I tell you what, your breath at dinner must honk in your family. Garlic bread, our survey says. Yes. It's up! Two more answers, you've got all your lives intact though, Brooke. Name a starter that's often on the menu.
Melon.
Melon. Yes,
nice one, Brooke.
Let's have a seat. For dancing, kid.
Hey, I like it. Well done. Melon, our survey says.
Yeah.
Yes. So we're looking for one more answer, Nicola, but you've got all three lives intact. What do you think?
Pate.
Pate? Yes. Nice. Yes. Pate. If you get this, you will have completed a full board without losing any lives, which is pretty amazing, trust me. You're saying pate. Our survey says... Yes! Yeah! Unbelievable! Well done, you! That's phenomenal! Excellent stuff. Well done, the Vincent. So at the end of round two, the McCarrons have yet to score. But in the lead with 178 is the Vincents! Yeah! All right, Marlon and John, come and join me and let's continue playing Family Fortunes. Yeah! Marlon, John, Marlon.
I'm Marlon. That's
me. One hand by your buzzer, one hand behind your back. Good luck, gentlemen. Here we go. It's the final round of Single Money. Every point's worth a pound. We surveyed 100 people looking for the top 7 answers. Name something you would do to let a guest know it's time for them to leave. From experience, Marlon.
Yawn.
Yawn? That's a good answer. You would yawn. Our survey says... Top answer. Well done. So, Marlon, do you want to play or pass?
Play.
We're going to play. All right. John, go back to your family, start conferring. You might get the chance to steal. Marlon, here we go. Nicole. What do you think? Name something you would do to let a guest know it's time for them to leave.
Start clearing away.
Start clearing away. Tidying up. Yeah. Our survey says... Yes! It's the third most popular answer. And, Nicole, you've won a spot prize. Take a look. It's yours tonight.
Sand, sea and some serious luxury awaits Nicole as you've just won a fabulous week for two to Dubai, courtesy of Oasis Beach Tower. You'll spend 7 Arabian nights in these stunning 5-star beachfront apartments where you'll enjoy delicious food, a complimentary spa treatment and dinner on board the Bateau Dubai. Sensational!
Amazing. Oh, well done, Nicole. Becca, what do you think? Name something you would do to let a guest know it's time for them to leave.
Put your pyjamas on.
You've got some style, your family. Wow, Rick. OK, you put your pyjamas on, you get ready for bed. Let's have a look. Our survey says... It's there! Get ready for bed. Well done. Well done, Becky.
Rick, I think get your friend or family or someone else to do, like, a fake phone call so you can kind of get out of it.
I like that, one of them. Oh, hello.
I've never done that before, though.
No. You're giving away all your secrets now. That's what you're doing. Right, so you do, like, a fake phone call?
Yeah, kind of, or a text message, fake phone call, yeah.
All right, let's have a look. Our survey says... It's not there. Unlucky. We're looking for four more answers. Mum, what do you think? What do you think, Mandy?
I can't think of one.
Can't think of one. Just give me anything. You're at a party. You want everyone to go. What would you do?
I'd go around with a black rubbish bag, putting all the stuff in it.
Yeah, well, I think we've had tidying up.
Yeah, I've had tidying up.
Yeah.
No, I said go.
You in the room, Mandy?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, timed out. Unlucky. Unlucky, Mandy. Unfortunately, you get timed out, which means you get one of these, I'm afraid. Unlucky. Unlucky. Marwan, back to you.
I find an excuse. Sorry, I have an appointment with the doctor or dentist.
Yeah. Yeah, that'll work at a cocktail party. Make an excuse like you've got to visit the dentist or the doctors, you know, at 11:30. Let's have a see if it's there. Our survey says... Oh, it's not there. He's just realising what he just said. Unlucky, unlucky. David, what do you think?
Tend to fall asleep.
Fall asleep. Grandma, John?
Ask them if they need a taxi home.
John?
Set the dog on him.
Send the dog on him!
Ask him what time the last bus is.
Ask him what time the last bus is. Brooke, you can have one of those or you can have one of your own answers. They're all good then, I think.
Should we do the one where you call a taxi? Yeah. I don't know how you'd put it in that, but call them a taxi.
All right, OK, you get them a taxi. You basically say, it's time to go.
Yeah.
Your cab's on its way.
Yeah.
For the steal, from the McCarrams, our survey said... It's not there. Unlucky. Well done. Well done, the McCarrams. Yeah, you won the point. Let's take a look at the seventh most popular answer. It was... Turn off the lights! The sixth most popular answer was... Look at your watch. Yeah, look at your watch. The fourth most popular answer was... Tell them. It really is that simple. Excuse me, it's time to leave. And the second most popular answer, which we failed to get, was... Get your coats. Get your coats. At the end of round three, the McCarrams have 50 points. But in the lead with 178, it's the Vincents. So far, McCarrams, it's not going to plan. Unless your plan was to fail miserably. But don't worry, don't worry. We've got two rounds of double money coming your way. It's all still to play for. You'll be all right. After the break, we will be playing double money because we're going to double the dosh. But first, yes, it's exciting. It really is. But first, let's see what you at home can win tonight.
This week, we're giving you the chance to win £5,000 in cash. Plus, we're also giving away an iPad 2 and £1,000 worth of iTunes vouchers. For your chance to win, just pick the top answer to this survey. We asked 100 people to name something that has feathers. Was the top answer A, hedgehog, B, cat, or C, bird? To enter, call 09012 934 500. Calls cost no more than £1.03 from BT landlines. Other networks may be higher and mobiles considerably more. Or text A, B or C as your answer to 88550. Text costs £1 plus one standard network rate message. Or enter online for free at itv.com. Entrance must be 18 or over and lines close at 4:30 p.m. next Saturday. Entries made after the closing time won't be counted but may still be charged. Good luck!
Of All-Star Family Fortunes, it's Emmerdale's Rick McCarran versus Coronation Street's Brooke Vincent. Will the boy called Sharma bring some good karma? Or will the girl called Brooke have all the luck?
Woo!
So far, the McCarrans have 50, but in the lead with 178, it's the Vincents! We'd like to find out if our families will manage to show an ounce of intelligence as we pile on the pounds. See what we did there? It's double money! Nicole and Grandma John, come and join me, please. John, Nicole, John. One hand by your buzzer, one hand behind your back. Good luck to you both. It's double money, every point's worth twice the price. Surveyed 100 people looking for the top five answers. Name a type of keeper. Nicole.
A zookeeper.
Zookeeper.
All right.
Let's see. Our survey says... top answer. Do you want to play our pass, Nicole?
Okay.
You're going to play? All right, Grandad John, you go back, start and confirm. You might get a chance to steal. We're going to play. Becca, I'll come to you. Name a type of keeper.
A goalkeeper.
A goalkeeper. Good answer. I like that. I like that a lot. That's a good answer. All right, let's see if it's there. Remember, it's double money. This could get you back into the game if you win this round. You're saying a goalkeeper. Our survey says... yes! Second most popular answer. Becca, you have won a spot prize. Well done. Congratulations. Look at Brooke. She's well jealous.
I'm looking to see what you've got again.
Congratulations, Becca. This prize is coming on with you tonight.
Ever feel like you've been taken for a ride? You'll want to be with this prize, Becca, as you've just won a matching pair of his and hers bikes courtesy of createbikes.com. So saddle up, put some power in your pedal and a smile on your face. Wheel spinning.
Oh, well done. Congratulations, Becca. You've won a couple of bicycles. Well done.
Thank you.
Rick.
Yes.
Name a type of keeper.
Shopkeeper.
Shopkeeper. Nice. You've got all three lights and we'll give you three more answers. We've had zookeeper, goalkeeper, shopkeeper.
Have a day off.
Come on. What?
What?
Unlucky, I thought that would be up there. That was a good answer. Mandy, what do you think, Mum?
Housekeeper.
Housekeeper. Yes. Yes. Housekeeper. Nice answer. Well done, Mandy. Let's see if it's there. You're saying housekeeper, our survey says. Look how confident they are, not even conferring.
We've done it.
Get ready, you might get a chance to steal. Marwan, what do you think? Name a type of keeper.
Beekeeper?
A beekeeper. Yeah. Yes. He's brilliant, really. He's quality. He's quality. Beekeeper, we like it. Let's have a look. Our survey says... yes, keeping you in the game. Keeping you in the game. He's gone full circle. Nicole, what do you think? We need two more answers, but you've only got one life.
A gatekeeper.
A gatekeeper. Yes, gatekeeper. Is it gonna keep you in the game? No, it's not. Unlucky, Nicole. David, what do you think?
Gamekeeper.
Gamekeeper. Grandad John?
I'll go with gamekeeper.
Gamekeeper as well, John?
Greenkeeper.
Greenkeeper, nice. Nicole?
Greenkeeper.
Greenkeeper. Brooke, you can have one of them or one of your own.
A gamekeeper, please.
Gamekeeper. All right, for the steal. For the McCarrams. Let's have a look. Our survey says... it's well done! Well done, indeed. 328 points. Well done, amazing. Let's take a look at the fifth and final answer, the missing answer.
Lockkeeper.
Lockkeeper, wow. At the end of the first double money round, the scores are... the McCarrams have 50 points. In the lead with a massive 328. It's the Vincents! Let's welcome our fifth family members, Becca and David, for the final round of Double Money. Come on. Becca, this is David. David, this is
Hi.
Becca. Good luck to you both. Final round of Double Money. We surveyed 100 people looking for the top five answers. Name someone that you might be nervous meeting for the first time. Becca.
Boyfriend's parents.
Boyfriend's parents. Yes, let's have a look. Our survey says... in-laws, yes. Okay. Becca, do you want to play or pass?
Play, please.
We're going to play. All right, David, you go back to your family, start conferring. You might get the chance to steal, and we'll come to you, Rick. Name someone that you might be nervous meeting for the first time.
Your date.
Your date. Yes, your date. Let's have a look. Our survey says... well done. New date. Fourth most popular answer. What do you think, Mum?
Bank manager.
Bank manager. Yes. Our survey says...
oh.
It's not there. It's not there. Unlucky. Now, Mandy, Rick's always been a dashingly handsome young gentleman, hasn't he?
He has, yeah.
Yeah, he has. We know that because we've got a young baby picture. Take a look at this. Look like a baby Danny DeVito.
Bit chubby.
Oh. 10 months old you were, though, apparently. Cute little baby. All right, name someone that you might be nervous meeting for the first time. Marwan, what do you think?
Prospective employer.
Prospective employer. Like at a job interview, that kind of thing.
Yes, yeah.
That's a good answer, but is it up there? Let's have a look. We're looking for one of three missing answers. Our survey says... it's there. Well done. New boss. I tell you what, Marwan... you're blooming good at this game.
Oh, thank
really
you.
Good at Family Fortunes.
Why do you call him Don Marwan?
Yeah, it's a pity you've only got 50 points, though. Isn't it? But you are outstanding, really good. Well done.
Thank you.
Nicole, what do you think?
The Queen.
The Queen, yeah. Is it one of two missing answers? You've got two lives left. Let's have a look. We're looking for the Queen. Yeah! You've got one answer to find, Becca, but you've got two lives left. What do you think? Name someone that you might be nervous meeting for the first time. Let's see if we can get a full board. Don't look too confident. Name someone that you might be nervous meeting for the first time.
I think a teacher.
A teacher at a new school. Teacher, I remember that day, yeah. Teacher, let's have a see. Is it the fifth most popular answer? It's not the Rick, head of the family, captain of the team. The pressure is on your shoulders. Do you walk away with 50 points or do you walk away with more? Because you're going to hopefully give me the missing answer, the fifth most popular answer, Rick. I don't know it, but telepathically I'm giving you all the help I can. Because to walk away with just 50 points is pretty embarrassing. Come on, Rick. The fifth missing answer for the final round of Double Money. On tonight's Family Fortune. Yeah.
A parent.
A parent.
Think about it.
Think about it.
I am. Not too hard, mate.
Luke, I am your father.
Exactly.
A parent. Is it the fifth most popular answer? It's not! Unlucky, Rick. David, what do you think?
A celebrity.
A celebrity. Grandad John.
Dentist.
Dentist. John.
A relative.
Relative, Nicole?
Doctor.
Doctor, yeah. Brooke, you can have one of those answers, or you can have one of your own.
Should we go with celebrity? I think a celebrity.
A celebrity. All right, it's Emmerdale versus Corrie. Corrie's in the lead. Our survey says... playing a little violin for you. So at the end of the main game, the McCarrams have 50 points. But the winners tonight, with 500 points, are the Vincents! We're going to play our Big Money final in just a moment, but unfortunately, we have to bid you farewell. It's been an absolute pleasure, and I think we've found a superstar. A real superstar. Marwan, you are a legend in this game. So well done. Absolutely brilliant. You played really well, but no one leaves here empty-handed, or no. You've got 50... you got 50 points. You're going to multiply that by 10, give you 500 quid. You know what? We'll make it £1,000 for your charity, Rick, which is, just remind us...
the Ashgate Hospice. They care for terminal patients.
All right, we'll give you £1,000 for those guys. And let's not forget Nicole. You're going to move on.
Yes.
Amazing prize. Becca, you've got those two bicycles as well, so congratulations. Have you enjoyed yourself?
Oh, yes. Absolutely.
Brilliant. Amazing. That's what we like to hear. They have been great sports. Give them a big round of applause. The McCarrams! Another award for Corrie. So, Brooke, the pressure's on. Which of your family are you going to come down the front and play Big Money with?
I'm going to take John with me, I think.
All right, John and Brooke, come down the front. Let's play Big Money.
Come on,
Brooke. There we go. So, after the break, we'll be playing our Big Money final. But first, here's your second chance to win big. Here's what you need to do.
For your second chance to win £5,000 plus an iPad 2 and iTunes vouchers, just pick the top answer to this survey. We asked 100 people to name something that has feathers. Was the top answer A, hedgehog, B, cat, or C, bird? To enter, call 09012 934 500. Calls cost no more than £1, 3 pence from BT Landline. Other networks may be higher and mobiles considerably more. Or text A, B, or C as your answer to 88550. Text costs £1 plus one standard network rate message. Or enter online for free at itv.com. Entrance must be 18 or over and lines close at 4:30 p.m. next Saturday. Entries made after the closing time won't be counted but may still be charged. Good luck!
Welcome back. Now, before the break, we saw the Vincent family win the main game, which means it's now their chance to win up to £30,000 for their charity. Now, Brooke has gone backstage. She can't see or hear us. So we're going to play, John. Big money. Good luck. All right, John, you've got 15 seconds to answer 5 questions. If you can't think of an answer, just say pass and we'll come to it if we've got time at the end. If you give me all 5 answers and you get 200 points, we'll give you £10,000 for your charity.
Okay.
If you and Brooke between you give me all 5 top answers, we'll give you 30 grand.
Okay.
So good luck to you both. Remember, time starts when I finish the first question. Can I have 15 seconds on the clock? Name something you might use to hit a ball.
A cricket bat.
Name a type of fish that people eat.
Haddock.
Name something you might rush to catch.
The bus.
Name a famous tower.
Alton Tower.
Name something that can be mint flavoured.
Chewing gum.
Well done.
Alton Tower. Oh, man. Pillow Tower.
I don't need to say anything, John. I really don't. Good luck, John. I love this show. Let's have a see. Remember, 200 points will get you £10,000, or 5 top answers will get you 30 grand. You need to get, John, about 100 points to make it easy, relatively easy, for Brooke. But remember, Brooke's playing. So if you could get over 190, that would be amazing. Name something you might use to hit a ball. You said a bat. Our survey said 47. Great start. Well done. Name a type of fish that people eat. You said haddock. Our survey said 20. 67. That's good. Name something you might rush to catch. You said the bus. Our survey said 35. Good. We've got 102. 2 answers left. Here we go. Name a famous tower. You said
years of ribbon.
Alton Tower. Oh dear. Our survey said no, it's not. Can you believe it?
I can't believe that's not there.
Alton Tower. Brilliant. Oh, I can tell where you spend most of your summer holidays. Oh. Name something that can be mint flavoured. You said chewing gum. Our survey said 26. Good, you got 128. That's really good. That means Brooklyn 72 to get £10,000. Well done, well done. Go back, join your family, John.
Good.
And let's welcome back Brooke. Good luck, Brooke. OK, I can tell you that John managed to score 128 points.
OK.
So you need 72.
OK.
For £10,000. If you get all 5 top answers, we'll give you 30 grand for your charity. So good luck, Brooke.
Thank you.
I'm going to ask you the same 5 questions. If you can't think of an answer, just say pass and we'll come to it at the end. Now, because it's a little bit more difficult, we're going to give you an extra 5 seconds, so you get 20 seconds in total.
Thank
if you give me an answer that John's already given me, you'll hear this noise. and I'll ask you for another answer.
Okay.
So, can I remind the viewers at home of the answers that we had from John, and can I have 20 seconds on the clock? Good luck. Name something you might use to hit a ball.
A bat.
Oh, a foot.
Name a type of fish that people eat.
Prawn.
Name something you might rush to catch.
A bar.
Name a famous tower.
Twin.
Name something that can be mint flavoured.
Mint.
You need 72 points.
Okay.
For £10,000, and you need all five top answers for Dirty Grand. Good luck, Brooke. Name something you might use to hit a ball. You said. Foot. Our survey said. 8. You got 136. Remember, we need 200 points for £10,000. Was bat the top answer? Yes, it was. Four more top answers and we've got £30,000. Name a type of fish that people eat. You said... prawn. Our survey said...
really?
I don't think it falls into the category of fish. Was haddock the top answer? No, it wasn't. I can tell you the top answer was cod.
Oh, cod.
It's easy now. So what we're looking for now is we're looking for 200 points. OK, so you need 64 to get £10,000. You've got three answers left. It can be done. Good luck. Name something you might rush to catch. You said... a ball. Our survey said... 4. We got... oof.
Oh, God.
I can tell you that bus was the top answer. Name a famous tower. We need 60 points in the last two answers. You said... twin. Our survey said... none. Unlucky. I can tell you the top answer is Eiffel Tower. Do you know where that is?
In Paris.
Well done. Well done.
Damn!
Yeah. Name something that can be mint flavoured. It's got to be worth 60 or more. For £10,000. Pretty obvious, but you never know. You said... a mint. Is mint the top answer? 60 or more for £10,000? Oh. I can tell you, chewing gum was a top answer. Chewing gum was a top answer. Unlucky Brooke. Come on down to the Vincent family. Come on in. Never mind. You played a really good game. Unlucky Brooke. Come on in, John. Right, I'll tell you what, you've been great sports. You played really well. You absolutely thrashed the McCarrams. You did ever so good. But you got 154 points in that round, and we're going to add that to your score from earlier on. We're going to multiply that by 10, giving you a total of £6,540 for your charity. So, well done. Just remind us what your charity was.
It's for When You Wish Upon a Star.
All right, it's a great charity. Congratulations. And let's not forget, John. You won that fantastic spa weekend for yourself, so congratulations. You'll enjoy that. It's great stuff. Have you enjoyed yourselves?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, brilliant. They've been great sports. I think you'll agree, ladies and gentlemen. Give them a big round of applause to Vincent! So big thanks to both our families. Join us next time when we play Family Fortunes. Good night!
Coming up on All Star Family Fortunes,
it's Robin Cousin! Don Steele!
You're all cousins.
And an uncle.
And I've got your school report.
See you next time!
Underlay, underlay!
Well, they're a picky bunch, those girls, and with good reason tonight. Take Me Out is at 8:05 before Rihanna is among the guests on The Jonathan Ross Show at 9:20. On the way, though, it's an all-new You've Been Framed.